see why you gave me that scripture, Lord.
Hallelujah.
We've all been told.
Bless you.
There's nothing that I can say here today that has not been said.
Amen. Hallelujah.
In every which way it can be said.
Amen. Hallelujah.
There's not an incident. There's not a relationship. There's not an emotion.
Jesus.
There's not a circumstance that has not been dealt with from every angle.
Amen.
I have declared unto you, I counsel you, counsel, instruct it, direct it, plead it, warn, scream, holler. Now, I'm not blaming you. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to get you to recognize where we are.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
There's no way that we can see the whole world. And remember, the abomination that make it desolate is a major sign.
Amen. Bless you, Jesus.
See how desolate you are?
Amen.
What do you mean? Well, we stand touch it 3 or 4 times.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
When you therefore shall see
Amen.
The abomination, an act, an abominable, detestable, an attitude, a mannerism.
Mm-hmm.
That is so abominable,
yes,
so react,
bless you, Jesus.
So vicious, so violent, so evil. Am I describing it okay?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Yes,
sir. Bless you, Jesus.
That's going to be the climax or the acclamation of the total depravity of this world.
Yes.
Coming to head.
Amen.
All of a sudden you say,
Amen. Amen.
Now you know that there's nothing that can be perpetuated in the world without first being done in the church.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So what we're witnessing today amongst God's people is abominations,
yes, sir,
after abominations,
yes, Lord,
after selfish,
yes, Lord,
vicious,
yes, Lord,
evil.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And the only hope you have.
Oh, glory, Jesus.
See? Cry and sigh.
Jesus.
Mark those who are going to cry and sigh for all the abominations that you commit, right?
Right.
No.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
I have the scripture. You don't like me, do you? Because that little book you hold in your hand comes alive out of me.
Hallelujah.
And all at once, that
Hallelujah.
Book, that book, that the letter that can kill.
Yes. Jesus.
God brings it to life by giving revelation of what it's saying.
Amen.
Because if we abide by that written word, we're dead.
Mm-hmm. Jesus. Amen.
It's the Spirit that
Hallelujah.
Makes it alive.
Amen. Bless you, Jesus.
See how little you know about that? You're learning the faith and sit there.
Jesus. Bless you, Lord God.
You know how abominable that is to sit around feeling sorry for yourself? That's what Job did. To where he got to the point where he loved not his life unto the death. Seems to me that that is part of the criteria to overcome this spirit.
Oh, yes,
Jesus. Yes, Lord. Amen. Bless the Savior.
Oh, last night we took the first one.
Mm-hmm.
The blood of
right.
Christ.
Hallelujah.
and they overcame him. Look at this. Now, you tell me that when I quote those words, that your mind says he's wrong? That's what your faces are telling me.
Oh, God. Bless you, Jesus.
You had all last night and even this morning. You were not to get yourself ready to come and to meet the Lord. Yeah, you did. You could have, just like I went in the ready room and I started preparing myself. And you know what I ended up doing? Abhorring myself.
Amen, my Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Yes.
Amen.
You don't like me when I tell you that. And they love. Not. You're not going to overcome this spirit as long as you love any part of this life. He'll keep feeding your life until he destroys you. You don't love that truth? I'm speaking words of life to you. You're so depraved.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
You're so desolate.
Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
That's why you're going to have to do some crying and sighing.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
This whole world today, I don't care what part you look at it, especially yours. The one you live in.
Amen.
The little world you live in.
Amen.
I remember Brother Kirk one day preaching about how everybody had their own little world.
Yeah.
Then he went out and lived in his own little world.
Yeah.
You ever realize how many things that you have spoken concerning what other people should do?
Help me, Lord.
Or you're actually telling yourself what you should do? You don't hate yourself for that? That thing that separated you from your brothers, your sister, your friends, your God, your family, your pride, your arrogance. What makes brothers fight against brothers? Huh? What makes husbands and wives fight amongst themselves? And see, because you will not love that truth, because you will not say, my God, the man is telling me the truth.
Yes, Lord.
Acknowledge the truth.
Yes.
Why?
Amen.
For the hope that you're going to get eternal life.
Amen.
Or is that, oh, I get it. That's not the life you want, is it? You want this life. So therefore you resist the truth. I don't care what anybody says. I don't care. You fuss at me, but I don't think there's ever been another man except the Apostle Paul that has been able to speak the Scriptures the way God brings them out of my life. And you say, what are you doing? I stand amazed. I'm an ignorant man. And all of a sudden, my mouth starts speaking words that are so clear, so precise, that I was, not you, though. No, to you. Why don't you do something about it? As I was sitting in the ready room, I thought, God, what are these days of unleavened bread? What are they? 7 days here. Why, these are the 7 days that Noah got into the ark.
Glory, glory, bless you, Jesus. Bless you.
Yes, 7 days now. He had to leave everything outside, didn't he?
Amen.
He had to get rid of all the malice. You can't take that in the ark with you.
No.
That's not so, son. You look at that young boy over there. He's sitting there looking at me. Boy, he likes to make us think he's intelligent. And all of a sudden, isn't that something?
Yeah.
You people think you have so much knowledge. Let somebody give you the truth, though. Ha!